On March 7, 2014, Frontline Defenders presented its annual award for human rights defenders at risk to Noorzia Afridi on behalf of her organization SAWERA, a women and girls' rights, empowerment, and development organization working in the federally administrated tribal areas of northwest Pakistan. Opening the ceremony, Chairman Dennis O'Brien called attention to the kind of risks that human rights defenders face every day.
These human rights defenders live in their home countries where they are followed home from work, receive anonymous and threatening calls in the middle of the night, have their homes frequently and offices broken into, jailed or be the target of a smear campaign because they tell the truth, have their children or their partner threatened because of their work, and worst of all, to have one's life taken away. It is difficult to imagine how they continue in the face of such risks.
Actor and humanitarian activist Sean Penn presented the award and noted both the significance of the work SAWERA is doing and the role that Frontline Defenders plays in working for the security and protection of human rights defenders worldwide.
When I hear the stories of all six finalists of this year's Frontline Defenders Award, I am humbled. When I think of what it means for these people to be human rights defenders, the isolation, the feeling of being a lone voice crying in the wilderness, the moments of doubt when you begin to question even your own deepest held beliefs, then I begin to understand the meaning of true courage. I'd like to salute the work of frontline defenders in helping to protect some of the bravest people in the world. People with hope in their hearts, passion to change the world by defending the rights of others, and the courage to challenge oppression. Noorzia and the staff of SAWERA continue to receive threatening telephone calls demanding that they cease their work, but despite the risk, they continue working to promote and develop women's rights in one of the most traditionally and culturally sensitive regions in Pakistan. This is why it is an honor for me to present the 2014 Frontline Defenders Award for Human Rights Defenders at Risk, which is accepted by Ms. Noorzia Afridi on behalf of SAWERA.
Noorzia Afridi remembered her sister Farida, who was killed on her way to work at SAWERA by militants opposed to their work in the region.
I hope the day is no longer ahead, too far distant, when the poor of our communities will be able to exercise and enjoy their basic human rights. They dream for their rights. We are their hope. And hope always forces you to survive. We have inherited this courage and determination from our co-founder, colleagues, and HR manager of SAWERA, Ms. Farida Afridi, who was shooted by militants in her home. She dedicated her life to educate girls, empower women, and help them to raise their voices on many issues affecting women in order to protect women's basic human rights. We are still committed and we have still lost our courage. If they kill one, a million will arise.
Frontline Defenders Executive Director Mary Lawler reviewed the work of the other five finalists, Berta Caceres, Alice Bilietsky, Lydia Mukami, Adilur Rahman Khan, and Mohammed Al-Roken, and then introduced the first recipient of the Frontline Defenders Award, Dr. Mudawi Ibrahim Adam from Sudan.
He has been held in police stations and prisons. He has been held on open ground in freezing, wet, windy conditions without any shelter. He has been held in solitary confinement. He has been held in the infamous, notorious ghost houses. He has been brutally treated, and trumped up charges, some of which carry the death penalty, have been fabricated against him. He is a man who has sacrificed much. He is a man who has faced personal and professional horror, yet who still refuses to give up, but continues to endure and spread light and life into darkness.
It is frontline defenders that keeps human rights defenders around the globe in their heart. Before this recognition, I was a regular customer of the Sudanese places of detention and ghost houses, and for long periods. The shortest was 3 months. Since my reception of the inaugural Frontline Awards for Human Rights Defenders at Risk I became a difficult target for the Sudanese authorities.
Frontline defenders salute SAWERA and all of the human rights defenders working for the organization in dangerous and difficult circumstances for their commitment to the rights of women and girls in Pakistan. Help protect human rights defenders on the front line. Contribute at www.frontlinedefenders.org/donate. Thank you.